Welcome to King's Kids. It's great to see you again today. We were so impressed with everybody who sent in videos of what you've been up to this week. We loved seeing your dancing, your worshipping, you getting involved in the challenges. So everybody who was involved was sent some treats in the post. So if you want to be involved, then feel free to send videos of what you have been up to this week as well. Let's take a look at last week's videos. Seeking you will find. Joy still comes in the morning. Hope still walks with the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, praise the Lord. Don't stop dancing and dreaming. There's still good news worth repeating. So lift your
going. Good job. What is happening?
Two. You got well done. Well done.
Turn the timer on so I can see it.
How are you doing now? Keep going, come on.
I've got the timer there.
Erin, you've got a lot of crumbs to eat up.
Back to the old sun.
Yeah. Don't throw them on mine if I'm going to throw up.
You're sucking the water out of my head.
See why I'm videoing and you're eating. And you're only on 38 seconds, you've got quite a bit of time.
Crack.
Keep chewing.
Good job, Erin.
You know what we're having for tea?
You've got to show me your empty mouth.
Playing crackers. Go on, Lucy. Daddy's finished! 59! Well done, Daddy.
Wow.
Teddy, you've got to have it all out of your mouth. Is your mouth clear? Right, I think Daddy was the actual winner. Right, let's see who's next. You have got a bigger mouth though.
Yeah. Well, it helps.
1:13, have we finished yet? Well, you can nearly beat Mike. Come on.
Might be Hannah.
Oh no.
Open your mouth.
Oh, good try though. Yeah. You've only got a small mouth.
Aaron's done it. Come on, girl.
Lucy's gonna be sick. Are you finished out?
Oh, Hannah's done it. Come on. Yay!
Finished, Ted?
Yeah.
Teddy was 1:37. Alice, are you finished?
Done.
Hello and welcome back to You versus Mike! Arr! And this week, we won! Yeah! Thank you to Matthew, who helps me win! So the 2021 score is 1-1 right now. Let's see how we got on with this challenge. This week's challenge, get some raw pasta and two plates. And then you got 30 seconds to get as much of the raw pasta onto the other plate. But there's a hitch. You can only use your mouth. Are we ready?
Mm-hmm.
3, 2, 1, go.
No, Mike, that's cheating. The plates are not allowed to move.
3, 2, 1, go. Come on, So I got 22 pieces onto my plate. Can you beat that? If you can, send in your videos and I would love to see you try.
Don't worry kids, I thought really hard about a challenge that your parents wouldn't want to do. So hopefully you will win this one. So this week, our worship challenge is learning a new song. I found some actions for it, so I'd love to see you trying them.
Why not give it a go?
So this week we are continuing on our new series about the church. Can you remember what we talked about last week, Permo? No, it wasn't chicken. Why are you thinking about chicken? Oh, you're remembering the bones. We did look at the dry bones and we looked at how the church can be like an army. This week we're going to look at a few different other aspects of what the church is like.
Have you ever heard the saying that the church is being made ready as the bride of Christ? It's just a way of explaining just how important the church is to God. You see, God loves the church, just like a husband loves his wife. And because he loves us that much, he wants what's best for us. In the Bible, we can see examples of what the church was like. And just after Jesus had left, in Acts 2, it says, "The believers studied what the apostles taught. They shared their lives together. They ate and prayed together. Everyone was amazed at what God was doing. They were amazed when the apostles performed many signs and wonders. All the believers were together, and they shared everything they had. They sold property and other things they owned. They gave to anyone who needed something. Every day they met together in the temple courtyard. They ate meals together in their homes. Their hearts were glad and sincere. They praised God. They were respected by all the people, and every day the Lord added to their group those who were being saved." Now, can you think of anything missing from that explanation? Why not have a read through and list the activities that the church did? Open up your own Bible and give it a go. So what did they do? They ate, they prayed, they were together, there were signs and wonders, they praised God and met needs, and people were added. It means that they become Christians and join them. And that's what church should be like. But they don't tell you anything about going to church on a Sunday.
Hey, what's the big deal about going to some building every Sunday? I mean, isn't God everywhere?
Amen, brother.
Now, going to church or watching church on your TV is good. Definitely. But the big message that I want to tell you today is that community is more important than attending a meeting. Being with people, eating, praying, seeing miracles, and sorting people's problems is discipleship. And it teaches us to be better people. And that is worship too. It pleases Jesus. It pleases God to see us meeting together, praying, seeing miracles, sorting people's problems, and learning to be better people. You see, the church is a team. It's a bit like being part of a football team. Yes, I know, I don't know much about football, but I can tell you this. We can each practice and become good players on our own. But if we want to work well as a team, we have to be together. We have to learn to recognise who is the best at defending or scoring or other parts of a football team. And we've got to learn tips from each other. You might be really good at encouraging people, but to do that, you've got to be around people who need encouraging. Now, right now, all the things in that passage might not seem very possible, and some of them might be a bit old-fashioned, because it was written a long time ago. So what could that look like today? How do you think we can build up Team Church in Manchester today? Why not write down some ideas? Or even better, make them happen.
hope you paid attention to those questions and prayer points. It's really important to discuss things and to chat things through with whoever you live with. And why not take a try at some of our suggested crafts? We've had a great week, everyone. And remember, we'd love to see your videos. Bye!